first local station with news in high definition. This is 9 News Now.
Care of cancer patients has changed dramatically over the last 10 years. We've got one of the world's most renowned oncologists here now to talk about the newest developments. Dr. Lewis Wiener is the new director of Georgetown's Lombardi Comprehensive Cancer Center. And I said it that way because it's a tough name. Some people pronounce it one way or the other. And we're just delighted to have you sitting here with us. Only been in town for 5 weeks. Have you found your way around? Are you getting settled?
I figured things out so far.
Yeah. Let me ask you about what's happened, because you've devoted your life to research. What are some of the areas, or what are some of the areas where you see significant improvements and advances that you're excited about?
Well, I think the most important change that I've witnessed in my career has been the application of science to medicine and the explosion of understanding that there is now about what causes cancer, what keeps cancers going, and what we need to do in order to treat them more effectively. And that's led to the development of a new era of targeted therapies, where instead of using nonspecific poisons to try and attack cancer cells, we now can target specifically the mechanisms that make cancers develop.
And when would you say that turning point occurred? Because you've been there in the trenches for a long time.
Well, I think when you're in the trenches, you don't always see the turning points, do you? I would say that in the late 1970s and early 1980s, we began developing some traction and understanding about what might cause cancer. And it's really been in the last decade or so that there's really been the consolidation of information that was needed in order for us to really understand how to go out and attack cancer cells more effectively.
Now, during the commercial break, we had a chance to visit, what about stem cell research? We hear so much about it. Do you see that as a pathway that is promising?
Well, I think you have to define what kind of stem cells you're talking about. In the public mind, there's a lot of discussion about embryonic stem cells. In my field, we don't talk about that so much. We talk about cancer stem cells. And the debate and controversy that exists is whether or not there are really such things as cancer stem cells. And if there are, how can we understand them more completely so that we can target those specific attributes that make a cancer stem cell survive, so we can obviously attack the cancer more effectively?
You say attack, and you've committed your life to this fight. How frustrating is it to move along? I imagine the milestones along the way. You said you can see that you can't even spot the turning points when they occur because you're too busy working on it. How tough is it doing what you do for a living?
I can't imagine doing anything else. I love what I do. The opportunity to give people hope, to offer them new treatments for their diseases, to allow them to achieve important milestones in their life, to offer the possibility of cure, and to always live in the future because of the excitement of research. You know, at Lombardi Cancer Center, we have mastered the art of merging cancer research with cancer care. And it's really important that everyone understand that research cures cancer, that by applying what we've learned about cancer most effectively, we can treat our patients most effectively and give people the tomorrows that they need.
Andrea Roan had a piece on this morning talking about families, looking at their family history. And when you start to look at all these pictures and all these people touched by cancer, it's remarkable, isn't it?
Cancer is a disease that affects almost everybody I know in one way or another. Everyone has been touched by the disease somewhere and somehow. And in fact, one of the things that we've learned is that there's good news and bad news. The good news is that in the past decade, the rate of cancer death and the actual number of people dying from cancer in this country has actually declined. And that's the first time in recorded human history that that's happened. And I am convinced that's occurred because of the exciting changes in understanding what causes cancer that have led to important new treatments. Having said that, we are all touched by cancer in one way or another. We have a long way to go. And it's necessary that we develop new treatments and new strategies for delivering those treatments so that we can give tomorrow's treatments in tomorrow's facilities.
All right, Dr. Wiener, thanks for coming in and welcome to town. Glad to have you here. For more information about breast cancer, go to WUSA9.com and click on BuddyCheck9. There you'll find Andrea's latest reports on efforts to fight the disease, plus her blog.